transcription as well as RNA processing. Transcription, during the transcription, mRNA is synthesizing here. So from DNA to mRNA is producing. Here on the transcriptional unit, promoter region, structural genes and terminator region are there. So the initiation of the transcription is meant by sigma factor, and elongation is continued by core enzyme of the RNA polymerase, where the termination, it means that the termination is done by the here one factor, that is the rho factor. When the rho factor is joined with the RNA polymerase core enzyme, it inhibits the elongation of the RNA transcription, as well as the it inhibits the transcription. It means there is a termination point. So at the termination point, the rho factor is joined to the RNA polymerase enzyme, there the termination is happened. So after the termination, the RNA, it means the formed RNA, is called heterogeneous RNA, also called pre-mRNA. So this is also called precursor mRNA. So why? Because it is precursor means here coding regions and non-coding regions are there. It means heterogeneous mRNA consisting of coding and non-coding regions, but the coding regions only used for the protein synthesis. Non-coding regions are not utilized for the protein synthesis. That's why there is a need of the removal for the non-coding sequences. What are the coding and non-coding sequences means? Exons are called as a coding sequences, introns are called as a non-coding sequences, also called as intervining sequences. So when exon segments are joined, then only the mRNA become matured. It means after formation of the mRNA, there is a need to go processing. So that is called RNA processing. So in the RNA processing, basically three major steps are happen. So the first step after formation of the mRNA, that is capping. The next one is polyadenylation, then splicing. So these three major steps are involved in the RNA processing. So you see here, during the transcription, after the transcription, the new transcript is formed, that is also called as nascent RNA, also called as hnRNA. hnRNA means heterogeneous RNA. Heterogeneous RNA is nothing but of it having the coding and non-coding sequences. So you see here, after production of it, so within the nucleus, it go for the modification. The first change, the first processing step is capping. So what is capping means? At the pi dash end, here there is a joining of guanine methyl triphosphate. Pi dash guanine methyl triphosphate is joined to the end of the pi dash end of the mRNA. Then the cap is fit. It means the capping is made. The cap is utilized for the, so the function of the cap is it makes some stability to mRNA before going to the translation. And where the cap is present, the site is binded to the ribosome. So it is also helpful for ribosome binding site. Okay, and this is capping. Next is, and the next end, what is the next end? 3' end. At the 3' end, polyadenylenes are joined. It means it is a tile enhancement. So tile is enhanced here, polyadenylenes are joined here, the tile is made. It means one is cap, another one is tail. So this is hnRNA. So no change, but two changes are made. One is cap joining, another one is adenylation. Then next one is splicing. Why the splicing is needed here? Already I told hnRNA means heterogeneous RNA. Here two types of the segments are there, coding segments and non-coding segments. The coding segments are called exons, non-coding segments are called introns. So the introns are need to remove here. So here already I told RNA is work as a RNA catalyst, self-catalyst. So self-catalyst means self-splicing. It acts as self-splicing agent. So the introns are removed, the exons, all our exons are joined in a specific manner to maintain the complete coding sequences of mRNA. Okay, so then only the mature mRNA is produced, and the introns are removed or spliced out from the HN RNA, so they are left. But only exons, exon 1, exon 2, exon 3, different species. So pieces are joined and maintain the linear form of coding of mRNA. So then only that become mature mRNA. So where happened? It happened in nucleus. But where the translation is going on? Actually the translation is going on at cytoplasm. But the transportation of mRNA from nucleus to cytoplasm, that must be happen. So how it is carried, how it be transported from nucleus to cytoplasm means, here special type of proteins are joined to mRNA. So mRNA, the mature mRNA is joined with proteins. Proteins, these proteins are help in the transportation of mRNA from nucleus to cytoplasm. So these two combination are called as informosomes. Informosomes. So informosomes are nothing but of proteins. The proteins are binded to the mature mRNA. They involve in the transportation of the mRNA segments. So from nucleus to cytoplasm. Then there at the ribosomal places the protein synthesis or translation process is going on.